Welcome to Pastel Languages with me, Leila. Hi. In today's video, we'll talk about some phrases for people who are coming to Thailand and staying at an ASQ hotel and need to communicate with some staff. All right. Without further ado, let's get into it. The first phrase that I've brought for you is when you want to ask somebody if they have something. So to have in Thai is me. It's the easiest word to say in the world. It's me. You just say the things you want to ask after the word me. So, and if you don't know the word for Thai, I'm sure you can Google translate it, or you can just substitute it with the English word for now, and then you finish that with the word might. Might in this case would mean do you, but in most cases it's just a word to add at the end of a sentence for the sentence to become a question. So here for the word me is have, and then you just put whatever here, the noun you want, and might means in this case, do you? Yeah. So is do you have me might, but we switch the location. So it's have, now do you. For ka is the ending, is like the ending polite particle in Thai. For a female, we say ka when it's a question, and we say ka when it's a statement. So in this case, if you're a woman, you say me something something my cat like this. Super easy. And of course, if it's a male person speaking, it doesn't matter who you're speaking to. It only matters what gender you are. You say me something something my cat. Now, an example that I can think of that you might need is a shower robe or a bathrobe. Now, it's a long word because we don't really have the word for bathrobe. So we have the word to explain what it is. So the word for bathrobe is chut klum ab nam. So chut means like clothing, klum means cover, and ab nam means shower. So a cloth to cover you when you shower or after you shower. So that's the name for bathrobe. That's why it's kind of long, but yeah, we'll do that for funsies. So me, we looked at me is to have. Now chut klum at nam. You don't need to remember this at this point if you want to be my guest. Chut klum at nam. My klap. If you are a male, you don't need to say krap, even though we have the cluster of kho khoai and lo lua, and it would sound very formally krap. You can just say cup, like a cup you drink from, cup. Mi chut krum ap nam, my cup, when you want a bathrobe from someone. Now, the next phrase we're gonna look at is when you wanna ask for something. Like, yeah, me is whether they have it. And in most cases, when you ask them if they have something, they know you're not just asking them just to check if they have it. You're asking them to see if they can provide that for you in this case where you're staying in an ASQ hotel. But this is when you know that they have it for sure and you wanna ask for it. So the word here is call. Call is literally to beg or to ask for. To ask for something. So call, ask for. Or beg. Yeah. Now, the second word is perm. So perm means more, like adding, add more. So perm means add more. It's when you already know that they have it or you've had it before, like they have given it to you and you ran out and you want more. So call dot 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 hum. And the last word is noi. Noi means a little. A little. And it's just a way to be polite. Because, like, can I have this more, a little, instead of, can I have this? You're like, can I please have this a little bit? Just a little bit, you know. So we always use it, the word noi is used a lot among Thais. Because it's polite. And you know that you're just adding it to make it sound softer, to soften it, you know. It doesn't mean that you want just a little bit. You want what you want. You're asking for what you're asking. Now, if you really don't want to remember, just remember the word call. Call is to ask for. And you add, and you use the word call, and you follow call with any noun. That means you're asking it. You will sound very impolite, but it will get the job done. If you say call tissue, and that is how we call toilet paper in Thailand. We don't distinguish between toilet paper or napkins. Or Kleenex, we just use tissue for everything, not tissue, tissue. Yeah, so call tissue. If you just say call tissue, they get you. If you want to be polite, you say call tissue noi. Call tissue noi. You don't need to say the word add more. It's not necessary. Call tissue noi. That's a lot politer. And if you want to be a little bit specific, like to tell them that I know you've given me, but I want more. So, call tichu pum noi, signifying that what you've had is not enough. Call tichu pum noi. Yeah. If you don't want to remember, then you ask call tichu. That's it. Next, an example is nam plao, meaning water. In Thai, we use the word nam to put in front of anything that's liquid. Detergent, we use the word nam in front of the detergent word for Thai because it's liquid. We use the word nam in front of juices. We use the word nam in front of soda. So we don't just say soda, we say nam soda, nam lemonade, nam orange juice, something like that. So that's why you can't just say call nam. Well, yeah, you can. They will get what you mean. They will get that you mean water. But to be specific, you say nam plao. Plao means, in this case, it means like pure or just this thing and nothing else. So nam plao. Plao can also say when you deny something. When someone asked you, you did something, you say plao. I didn't do it. Yeah, you can use it in that way too. So, call nam plao pum noi. I know you gave me water, it ran out, I want more. Call nam plao pum noi. Okay, next phrase is when you say I want. So the word I, if you are a female, it's chan. It's written as if it's pronounced chan, but nobody says chan. So people always say chan with the high tone, chan, chan, chan. Yeah, and then the next word is ya. Ya is what. But if you just say ya without saying the next word, you have to follow it with the verb. So if I say I want to run, I say chan ya wing. But I cannot say chan ya nam plao. Or I want water. No, you have to add the word dai. So ya dai together means want that is followed by a noun. So this means itself means want, but you need to add this word. So dai means okay in some cases, but in this case it means receive. So I want to receive And then in the middle is a noun that you want. If you're a woman, you end the sentence with ka. Ka. ฉันอยากได้ทิชชู่ค่ะ ฉันอยากได้น้ำเปล่าค่ะ ฉันอยากได้ชุดคลุมอาบน้ำค่ะ But if you're a man, then you say ผม And ผม is the pronoun for a man to call himself. Again, doesn't matter who you're talking to, only matters who you are. ผม also means hair. I know. ผม means hair, and it's the word for a man to call himself. ผมอยากได้, and you end the sentence with ครับ. Like I said, no need to say ครับ, just say ครับ is fine. ผมอยากได้, with, and follow it with the noun, ครับ. An example is when you want a towel. The word for towel in Thai is ผ้าขนหนู.ผ้า means fabric, ผ้าขนหนู, ผ้า means fabric, ขน means hair that's not on the head. Any hair that's not on the head, we call ขน. The hair that's on the head, we call ผม. หนู means rats or mice. So in the word for towel in Thai is the fabric,That's made of rat hair. I know, it's very disgusting. That's how we call Thai. That's how we call towel in Thai. Is ผ้าขนหนู. ฉันอยากได้ผ้าขนหนูค่ะ. I want towel. No need to say a towel. No need to say towels. In Thai, we do not change the noun according to how many.We want. We don't add s to the end of the word. We don't need to have a or an or the. It's just I want towel. Okay. Now, those are the phrases I think will be very useful for you when you want to ask for something. Now, this sentence means that the room is not clean yet. Now, I want to be polite.And I don't want you to go out and say, the room is not clean. So, you should say, the room is not clean yet. Because by adding a few words, it softened it a lot in Thai. And Thai people will appreciate it. Because you get the point across, but you also don't infuriate them. So,ห้องยังไม่สะอาด This is how you say it. ห้อง means room. ห้อง room. Any room starts with the word ห้อง. Bathroom is ห้องน้ำ. น้ำ means water. We talked about it. So ห้องน้ำ means the room with water. That would be the bathroom. ยังis yet.Yang is yet, so it's not clean yet. Yeah, mai is not mai in Thai is no and not and don't. We use the same word. That's why if you go to the market and you want something, the seller might say no have, no have. That's because we don't distinguish between no.Not and don't. That's what they should be saying is don't have or I don't have. But in Thai, if every sentence doesn't have to start with a pronoun, that's why you don't need to say chan something something or pom something something all the time. That's because in Thai, the subject of the sentence doesn't always need to be there. We know what you mean. You don't need to put yourself in the sentence. You still.We still understand you. So, again, that's why they say no have, because they mean to say I don't have, but the word for no is the same word for don't. So, room, yet, not. Sa at means clean. Clean. And then, clap. ห้องยังไม่สะอาดค่ะ. ห้องยังไม่สะอาดครับ. Okay. Now, if they really don't get your message, you need to tell them, please clean my room. This is the sentence to say, please clean my room. So we start with the word 出位. Now 出位 means help. Help. 他们 means do. 他们 means do. And ความ สะอาด. So we looked at สะอาด. สะอาด means clean. 사아드 means clean. 꽝 is the word to be attached to an adjective to make it a noun or adjective or verb. You know, you can put the word 꽝 in front of adjective or a verb to make it a noun. So in this case, 꽝 doesn't mean anything. It's just in front of clean to make it mean cleanliness. Noi, again, we looked at noi already. Noi means a little, a little. Ka is the ending for when you're female. So help do cleanliness. A little. Help do, the whole thing is cleanliness. Help do cleanliness a little. Chuai tam kwam sa'at noi ka. And the word ทำความสะอาด altogether just pretty much means the clean, the verb version of the word clean in English. Because the word in English, when we talk about clean, it can be an adjective, like this room is so clean, or it can be a verb where I need to clean my room. But in Thai, 사아드 is an adjective, and if you want to turn it into a verb, you have to add 탐, which means do, and then 꽝, which makes 사아드, makes clean to be a noun. So it's a make cleanliness or do cleanliness, help do cleanliness a little. When learning a language, you can't really use the structure of the language you use. You need to erase how you think a sentence should be. Like today, you know that a Thai sentence does not always have to start with a subject. That's probably new to some English speakers, but you really can't force the structure of your language on the language you're trying to learn. I hope this video is useful. Let me know if you have questions. I'll see you in the next video. Hope this is useful. Bye!